Hey everyone, here's how to make this Wave Warp Plus Zoom transition on Premiere Pro. This is the finished result and the Sapphire plugin is optional if you want to make these zoom transitions just like I will in this video. So let's get started. So as I just said, you need to make zoom transitions. So if you don't know how to do that, then check out my detailed tutorial on blur mode curves, because I'm just going to very quickly speed run the transition. So I'm going to head into my project tab. You want to right click new item, adjust layer, and click OK. Place it on top of your clip and extend to match the duration. So I'm going to be using blur mode curves, this one right here. And I'm gonna keyframe the Z disk at the start and then set another at the last frame. Let's go for 0.8. And then I'm gonna increase, actually, I'm going to decrease the second value for the center XY. So let's go for, I think that might be a little bit too high. So maybe something around 180. So let's just test that. Okay, looks great. So what I'm gonna do is graph it. So head to your last frame, one frame back, and look at the velocity. So this should not dip below zero, or should I say above. It can dip below zero, but it should be as close as it can to zero. So there you go, perfect. It should look like this. I'm just going to tighten up a little, pressure handle to the left. Okay, looks perfect. So what I'm going to do now is just push this keyframe back and add on blur mode curves once more and do the reverse. So I'm gonna set this value to 180, just like the one for my first blur mode curves effect, and set a keyframe for the Z dist. Add another for the last frame. Let's go for 0.8 again. I don't know how that's going to look. So what I'm gonna do first is graph it, and once again, use the velocity. So I'm just gonna pull it to the right, pull it up. There you go, hit zero, looks perfect. Just gonna tighten it up a little, like that. All right, let's take a look at how it looks. Okay, not bad. I'm just gonna test to see if the zoom looks okay with my other clips. Okay, looks perfect. So what I'm gonna do is collapse the effect. Next, I'm going to duplicate the adjustment layer over to my other clip. So hold Alt on your keyboard, click and drag to place it over them like that. And you might need to make some adjustments depending on the duration of your other clips. So feel free to open them up and move the keyframes around. It might take a little while, but we're focused on the main effect, which is the wave warp. So what you want to do first of all is nest your clips. So as you can see, I've got no effects on them. What we're going to do is add on the wave warp effect. Where is it? Underneath distort, directly onto our clip, since it doesn't really work on an adjustment layer for some reason. So make sure your video layer has no effects on either of them. And what you want to do is nest it. So right click, nest, okay, and repeat for your other clips. I've got a hotkey set, so it's easy for me. All I have to do is control N. So control N for all of these. And then what I'm going to do is search for wave warp. So this one right here, I'm going to add it onto my clip directly. And all you need to do is just copy my settings. So the first one is the wave type. You want to set this to smooth noise. And the height you want to set to 125. The wave width should be set to 55. And the direction should be 0. The wave speed, leave that at 1. The pinning should be all edges. And the anti-aliasing should be set to high. Next, set a keyframe for the wave height at the beginning. Head 5, 10, 15 frames ahead and set this to 0. Then open up the graph. And what we're going to do is just head one frame back because we're going to use the velocity to help us. So what you want to do is grab the handle for the second keyframe, pull it all the way to the left. Make sure you pay attention to the velocity because this should not go higher than 0. So negative 0.2, that's fine. So yeah, that's done for the second keyframe. I'm also going to make a few adjustments for this one. So what you can do is just right click on it and select Bezier. And what you want to do is just, if we just expand this, you want to move this handle down. Now, if it won't go back for whatever reason, probably another bug that Adobe haven't fixed, what you can do is push the keyframe forward and then move this handle down like that. There you go, something like that. And then push the keyframe back and your graph should look something like this. I'm just going to push my other handle a little higher. You can see it kind of dips here. So I'm just gonna push it up. There you go. So before, after, looks perfect. In fact, I might just push this up slightly like that. Okay, now let's take a look at how it looks. Perfect. So that's the first wave warp done. We're going to add on one more. So just collapse this one by clicking on the arrow next to it. Add on wave warp to your clip one more time. And what you want to do is head to your last frame. So this one right here. And you want to change the wave type to smooth noise. Set the height to 75, the width to 20, and the direction to 0. And pinning to all edges. Anti-aliasing, I still can't say that. Set it to high. And what you want to do for your last frame is set a keyframe for the height, then head 5-10 frames back and set the height to 0. Now we're going to graph it, but it's going to be in reverse. So open up the graph and again, pay attention to the velocity. You want to grab this handle, pull it all the way to the right and push it down until it reaches 0. Perfect. And then I'm going to make some adjustments to my graph here on the right. So I'm just going to pull it down. I think that should be okay. Let's take a look. It's not too noticeable, but I think that's the point. It's meant to be very subtle. So we're going to leave it at that. If you don't like it, you can always increase the amount of wave height and also push this handle back. So then it appears for longer, as you can see. But I'm going to leave it as it is. And then what I'm going to do is collapse this effect. Now to copy it over to your other clips, all you need to do is hold Control on your keyboard, select both, starting from the top, so first, second, right click, copy or Control C, highlight your other clips, and Control V on your keyboard. That's going to paste them, so now if we play it back, that's pretty much everything you have to do. If you would like to grab 50 presets, including this one, then make sure to check out my premium presets pack in the description below. There are shakes, there are transitions, colorings, and much more. If you're interested, then check out this video here. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace.